Hey guys, so welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can add a new font to ImageMagick. So if you install ImageMagick, it comes with a list of fonts, but you might want to, you know, add to that list of fonts. And in this short video, I'll show you how you can do that. So I have my terminal open here, as you can see. And what I want to do first is I'd like to list the fonts that ImageMagick kind of has. And we can do that by typing convert, and then we can list the option. We can do list like this, and we can do font. So again, convert is a command that we're going to use to list all the fonts that are available for ImageMagick. And convert actually comes with ImageMagick. So once you install ImageMagick, convert will be installed with it. And it can be used to do a few things. One of them is to kind of list the fonts, but it does other kind of more important things like converting kind of image formats. So I'm going to hit enter now, and you will see here I have the list of fonts that are available. And of course, we can just, you know, scroll through them and search for the ones that, you know, we want to use and make sure that it's there. But another better way for searching for fonts would be to use grep. So let's say we're searching for a font with the name Lane, and this is really what I want to add. Lane is a free font that I tend to use, and I'd like to add it to ImageMagick. And we can search for it here, and what we can do is we can do the same command, convert, with option list, then font, and then I want to pipe it with a grep command. So if you have a grep like this, and with option I, which stands for case insensitive, and then between double quotations, we can do Lane. Essentially, what that's going to do, that's going to take the output of this command, which is essentially all of what you're seeing here, and line by line, it'll try to find this word, Lane, without it being kind of case sensitive. So this I means that it doesn't have to be exactly like this. It could be all uppercase, or L can be uppercase. And it'll match it, and it'll return all the lines that contain this word Lane. So if we do this, you notice that there's no lines that contain Lane, meaning that Lane is not really in the list. Now, if we try something else, let's say we can try this one, Palatino, and I'm going to go up, which will be kind of the last command, and I'm going to replace Lane with Palatino. And if I do this, you will see that it returns all the lines that contain the word Palatino. So we have Palatino here, here, here. So these are the lines that contain Palatino. And because this command returned nothing, that means we don't have Lane. So the first thing that we want to do to add Lane to ImageMagick would be to download Lane. So we want to download Lane from the web, and then we're going to add it to the list of fonts here. So let's do that. All right, so before we go and download Lane, let's make sure that we don't have Lane kind of already installed on the operating system. So I'm going to open my font book. So I'm going to go here, I'm going to say font book, and I'm going to search for Lane just to show you that I actually do not have it installed on my Mac OS. So we already know that it's not installed, or it doesn't, it's not kind of included or contained in ImageMagick, but it might be installed in our operating system, but it isn't, and I can show you that here. I'm going to search for Lane, and you can see that the number of fonts that contain Lane is zero. So I need to kind of install it. Maybe a good idea would be to install it on my machine and then kind of add it to ImageMagick. All right, so as you can see here, I googled Lane font, and I'm going to click on the first link here, and this is really the font, and I do want to download it. It comes actually in four different kind of styles, and when you download it, it'll download all of them, and we just want to install the first one. So let me click on download and download it. So you can see I have the font downloaded. I'm going to double click on it, and that'll unzip it. And inside this folder, you can see that we have four different kind of fonts. And I want to install the first one. And if you double click on it, it'll actually preview it. Actually, I don't want to install this one. Let me install the second one, which is the regular one. and I'm gonna just simply click here, and that'll install it on my macOS. So as you can see here, this is the font book. You can see that lane has been added, and if you search for lane, you will see that it'll return the, you know, this item here. So I'm gonna close this one, and I'm gonna close this one, and I'm gonna show you that even though we've installed it on macOS, we still don't have it kind of available for ImageMagick. So if you do convert again, and we do list, and we do font, and if we grip and we search for lane like this, you will see that it still returns nothing, meaning that even though it's installed on macOS, we actually do not have it yet on ImageMagick. All right, so let us add lane to ImageMagick. Now to do that, we need to first locate the folder that contains ImageMagick. Now I told you earlier that convert actually comes with ImageMagick. So we can run the command which convert, and that'll tell us where convert is. And convert is inside kind of this folder bin inside homebrew inside opt. And I used homebrew to install ImageMagick earlier, and that's why convert and ImageMagick both are in homebrew. So let me open my finder and let me go to this folder. And I can do that from the terminal by typing open, and then I can do opt homebrew bin like this. And that'll open finder. And again, I'm inside this folder homebrew and bin. And what I want to do is, I don't want to go to bin. I actually want to go to opt. And inside opt, I want to go to ImageMagick. So you can see here, here's ImageMagick. It doesn't really matter which one you choose. And inside ImageMagick, you can find Etsy. And inside Etsy, you find another ImageMagick. And here you see two important files. One of them is type.xml, and the other one is type ghost script. So let's open type. So I'm going to double click on it, and it'll open in PyCharm. And what you see now, when we wait a few seconds, what you see here is this file is importing or including another file, and the other file is type ghost script. So let's open type ghost script and see what's in it. So I'm gonna go back here, let me double click here. Okay, so this file contains the list of fonts that are available for ImageMagick. So all of those fonts that you see here are available for ImageMagick, and I'm gonna show you something here. I'm gonna comment some of them and show you that if we try to search for the fonts after we've commented, you know, some of them, the list will be different. So how about we search for Bookman Light? So I'm gonna go to my terminal and I'm gonna search for Bookman Light. So I'm gonna say convert, list, font, and then I'm gonna do grip, and I'm gonna do I, and then I'm gonna say Bookman, was there a dash? Let's see. Yes, there's a dash. So Bookman dash light. And you can see here, it returns two fonts. We have Bookman Light and Bookman Light Italic. So if I go here and if I comment these two lines, then I can do that by doing the following, doing exclamation point here, and then two dashes. And then at the end of this line, let me kind of go here, and I'm gonna do two dashes here. And that'll actually comment these two lines, and I'm gonna save the file. And I'm gonna go back here and I'm gonna go up, and I'm gonna try to run the exact same command, and you will notice that the two fonts are not kind of here anymore, and that's because we've commented them. So let me go here and uncomment them. And after that, we'd like to add, you know, the font that we installed, which is lane. So what we should do here is we should create a new type element or type tag, and we should give it some attributes. We don't have to give it all the attributes that you see here, but there are a few attributes that we have to give it. But before we do that, let us find the path of the font lane. As you can see here, all of those fonts have, you know, paths, and we need to find the path of the font that we want to add. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go back here, and I'm going to actually open a font book. So let me do that, font book here, and I'm going to search for Lane. Well, here it is. I'm going to right click on Lane, and I'm going to show in Finder. So what I'm doing here is I want to find the path of Lane so that I can add it to the list of fonts here. And one way to do that would be to show in Finder. And as you can see, when I click on show in Finder, this Finder window opens, and this is really the font that I want to find the path for. And I can do that by right clicking. And here's a trick that's really kind of useful. If you hold the Alt or Option key, you will see that copy is going to be switched to copy the file as path name. And that way you're actually copying the path to this file. So if you just copy, it'll copy the file. But if you hold Option or Alt, it'll actually copy the path of the file. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to copy this. And then I'm going to go back here, and I'm going to create a new, again, element. And you can see it actually filled all of that, all of those attributes. And I don't want those attributes, so let me actually do it manually. So I'm going to do type, and I'm going to say name is going to be called Lane. That's the name that I'm giving it. And then there is format. Format is necessary. And the format of the file is going to be the extension. So here it's a TTF file. So the format is TTF. And of course, I need to give it the glyphs. So the glyphs, again, is the path to the font. And since I copied, and I can do it again here, I'm going to hold Option, copy the path, or the essentially the path, and I'm going to paste it here. And as you can see, when you paste it, it'll actually paste, you know, the path to the font. And I'm going to close, this element or this tag. And that's it. Now, I'm going to save this. And I'm going to go back to my terminal. And I'm going to actually search for Lane now. So I'm going to search for Lane. And I still don't have Lane. Interesting. So what did we do wrong? Let's see. Oh, so this type, actually, we want to close it. This is going to be like this. Let me save it. And let me try to search for Lane again. And you can see that I do have Lane here. This is the font, and this is the glyph. And just to show you that this font actually is indeed installed on ImageMagick, I can write a Python script, and I can use this font to display something and in that particular font. So let's do that, and we'll end the video once we do that. All right, so I just created an empty project using PyCharm. The first thing that I want to do is I want to install MoviePy, and I can do that by doing pip install MoviePy. All right, so it's done. So from MoviePy.editor, I want to import star. I'm going to say text clip equals to text clip, and then I'm going to say something. So I just copied this code and I pasted it here, and I'm going to pick the font, and the font is going to be Lane, and the font size is going to be maybe 40, and the color is going to be maybe white, and that's it. We can try to save this text clip. So I can say text clip dot save frame, and I can say out.png. Let me hit play. So it's finished, and you can see that there's an out.png. If we double click on it, we don't see the font because, you know, it's white with transparent background. So let's actually change the background. Let me change this to black, and let me hit play, and you will see that if I double click here, you will see that this is the, you know, the text clip. And this is actually the lane font. I know the font and I know that this is lane. You can see this, what you see here is actually identical to what you're seeing here. You can see the T. The T is very unique. I don't like this T actually, but let's look for the T. RST. Let's look at the lowercase T. Huh, where can we find the lowercase T? Here. Here's the lowercase T. And you can see that it's identical. Okay. All right, guys. So I hope that was useful. And let me know if you have any questions in the comments below.